Now we're going to focus on three things that you may want to do at the end of the school year: copying, archiving, or transferring. So first, let's start with copying. If you're happy with most of your classroom and you want to reuse the majority of it in the following year, now you're able to create a copy of your class. So what you'll want to do is go to your hamburger menu and go to the Classes tab so that you can find your class card. On the class card, there's a three-dot menu. If you click on the more options, you'll notice that you can copy the class. When you click copy, what I want you to notice is that when you create a copy of a class, you get copied topics and copied classwork. You won't have the students in your new class, and it won't copy any announcements. But remember, if you needed to reuse a post, you could always reuse posts for announcements. But it pulls your students out and creates a copy of your class, and everything in your class becomes a draft. So you can choose to reuse it or not. So the first thing that you'll want to do is change your class name. So since this is going to be a copy of my class and I'm going to use it for the following school year, I'm going to rename my class. I can type in my section, subject, and room, or those are things that I can come back later and do. Now, depending on the size of your class, it may take a while to copy. So I'm going to click copy so that you'll see the announcement that comes up. It does start copying your class, and it may take a while. Sometimes it will take a while and you'll get an email saying when it's ready. You'll notice it created a copy and it's still creating. So after a while, I will come back and see my classroom. So that's creating a copy. Now that it's ready, you'll notice that it has zero students, and I want to open it so that you can see it. So my copy of the class, again, did not copy my announcements on the stream tab. And on the classwork tab, everything is in draft format. Students won't see a topic until there has been an item posted associated to that topic. So right now on the classwork tab, my students aren't seeing anything because nothing has been posted. Once you're ready to post something, you simply open it up, click edit, and then you can post or schedule. So it's great because you can decide, well, you know, this assignment didn't work very well, so I'm going to delete it, or maybe I'm going to move it into another topic. But basically, everything that you used in your previous class, except for students and except for announcements, is going to be brought over to a new semester or a new school year. So again, that's copying the class. I'm going to go back to my classes tab, and now we're going to focus on archiving. So one of the benefits of archiving is that it removes the class from your classroom main screen. So you can see I have a lot of classes here that I'm currently teaching. And if I didn't archive them, this would grow exponentially. So what I'm going to do is when I'm finished with a class, I've made a copy of it, I'm now going to archive that class because I don't need to go into it on a daily basis, but I do want to keep the content that's within it. I want to keep my student work, I want to keep my grades, but I don't necessarily need to see it on the front tab, and my students don't really need to go into it to perform any more functions or turn in any assignments. So I'm going to go to that three-dot menu again, and this time I can choose to archive the class. Now when I click on that, I want you to see what this says. They can't be updated unless you restore them. So I can have the option to restore it if I need to, but also it's going to move to my archived classes and all the files are going to stay there. So everything my students have submitted are going to stay in the Google Drive that's associated to that class, so I can always access it again, but it basically just makes it inoperable. So I'm going to go ahead and choose archive. And what you'll notice is that takes that classroom off this tab. And so now I'm ready to use my 21-22 class. Now, if for some reason it was a mistake and I didn't mean to archive it, or if I want to see my archived classes, to reach the archived classes, you go to the hamburger menu, scroll down to the bottom and you'll see archived classes. So when I click on archived classes, what you'll notice right away is that there are little stripes across the picture showing that it's kind of an old class. Some of my classes I took the students out first and some of them I didn't. But an archived class means that the students can go to their archived classes to get to their content, but they're not going to be able to turn in anything or that kind of thing. But it also keeps my classes intact. So I could open it and take a look at it, but it says classes archived, restore it if you want to add or edit. But if I don't want to add or edit anything and I just kind of want to go in and see my students' work or access their assignments, I still can get to it. So that's how you access archived classes, hamburger menu, archived. So we've talked about copying a class and archiving a class. Now I want to talk about the scenario where you are transferring or you're going on a leave and you need someone else to take over the responsibility of the class for you. So I'm going to open up this class and I'm going to go to my People tab. And Jane Doe has been a co-teacher in here, but I'm getting ready to leave my school district and I know that my students are still in here and I don't want when I leave for my account to be disabled and this classroom goes away. So one of the things we recommend is if you are getting ready to leave the district or go on a leave, or maybe you're using classrooms with the club and you're no longer the club sponsor, whatever the reason, if you need to give over responsibility to someone else, you'll want to make them a teacher first. And then after they've accepted to be a teacher, one of the things that you can do is make them the class owner. So I'm going to transfer ownership to Jane Doe, and it says you'll remain the owner until that invitation is accepted. So they're going to get control of the class. That means they can delete it, but it also means if my account is disabled, I'm just going to be disabled as a teacher. The classroom itself is not going to be disabled because I don't own it anymore. So I'm going to go ahead and invite Jane to be the owner of the class. And when she accepts that, she will be the owner. And so if my account gets disabled, this classroom can still function. So that's a very important thing to remember, is if you're leaving, transferring, whatever the case, if you want someone else to be able to still use your classroom, you're going to want to transfer ownership. So the three things that we've talked about are copying, archiving, and transferring ownership.